inside outside the gate to sanctify the people by his own blood. Let us go to him outside the camp, bearing in himself which he bore. For here we have an elastic city. We are seeking one which is to come. Through him, let us continually offer God a sacrifice of praise, that is, the fruit of lips which acknowledge his name. Do not neglect good deeds and such generosity. God is pleased by sacrifices of mankind.
Peace be to you, reader.
Wisdom be attentive.
Tells us in the gospel, I am the light of the world. St. John in his gospel says that he is the light of the entire human race. And as long as light is in the world, darkness shall never overcome. How many know that that is good news? How many know that we live in a world that gets increasingly darker by the moment? More decadent, more evil, and more empty of God's goodness and love. Anybody watch the news last night?
Yes.
Evil personified. It lives among us. And it's perpetrated by those among us. The good news is it's not much different than in the time of Jesus. Because when right before they snuffed out John the Baptist, who was announcing the coming of the good news, Herod was evil, dark, decadent. He threw himself a large party, and at that party, his wife, illegitimate as she was, asked for the head of the forerunner. Jesus was opposed by those who were in leadership, both religious and political. There wasn't much difference back then. The Pharisees and the Sadducees were the political leaders, and they were more concerned about their own power, about what they could receive, rather than taking care of and leading the people at that time. Sound familiar? Still exists today. But there's good news. And we hear it right in the first line of the gospel. You are the light of the world. A city raised on a hill cannot be hidden. The light shines forth from that city. How many know when Jesus refers to city, he's talking about the city of God? The city of God is what? The church. And the church is you and I. We are called to shine the light that lives within us out into the darkness and illuminate, to expose all of the evil and to renounce it not only to ourselves, but to those that we meet. And maybe to some who are perpetrating. You remember the story when Jesus, in Luke's gospel, when Jesus sent out 70 apostles out into the lands and told them to go out and to cure the sick and to lay hands on them and they will be well, and that he gave them power and authority to go up against serpents and scorpions, and they came back rejoicing because demons and devils were expelled by them using the name of Jesus. How many know that you and I have that power? Oh, yes, we do. Jesus tells us right in the gospel, I have given you power and authority to trample over serpents and scorpions and to go up against every tactic of the devil, and nothing shall harm you. How many know that's good news? We have power. St. Paul tells us in his letter to Timothy, I have given you a spirit, not of fear or timidity, but a spirit of power and of love and right-mindedness. We have to put on the heart and mind of Christ. I mean, the reason we come here is to pray, to give thanks to God, to be fed by his word, and to receive the body and blood of our Lord, to receive the Eucharist, because it strengthens us. It gives us what is necessary for us to go forth from here and to live upright, good, Catholic, Christian lives. When we come here, it's like putting a lamp in the charger. and getting a full charge so that we can go forth fully illuminated and shining the good light of Christ upon everyone that we meet. How many remember 9/11? After that, the churches were packed. You would do better getting a seat at a rock concert than you could in a church immediately after 9/11. Then we had COVID. Of course, they locked the churches. That's the evil that was personified then. If we wanted to pray, we couldn't get in for a while. And now we see that that evil still rears its head. What do we do? Those of us who are in the light were called to pray. To pray not only for ourselves and for our families, but to pray for our world leaders, some of whom may not know Christ. We're called to fast. If you remember the story of the apostles that couldn't drive out the demon, they went to Jesus and said, "Why could we not drive him out?" And Jesus said, "This kind can only be driven out by prayer and fasting." If we want to overcome evil, if we really want our light to shine, fasting and prayer is the answer. And of course, the third one is good works, almsgiving, giving of ourselves, giving our time, giving our talent, giving our treasures, being present to our community, and being Christ to them. Then we're going to make a difference. Then people will begin to see through us that goodness does indeed overcome evil, that the light in us outshines the darkness. So let's take time this morning as we continue to pray this divine liturgy, lifting up all of our world leaders, praying for those in government who were elected to lead us, that they may see the light of Christ, and that we may be illumined enough to choose the right leaders to lead us forward. And that we ask Jesus, who we heard in the epistle, is the same yesterday, today, and forever. That God teach us that we're not led astray by all kinds of strange teaching. The early fathers of the church, who we commemorate this morning, had the same issues that you and I encounter. And every now and again, to put things back on track, they would call a council. And that's why we celebrate the 6 ecumenical councils this morning. That they spoke out the truth, who is Jesus, into the evil or the disinformation that existed at the time to put things back on track. God calls you and I to be the light in the darkness so that the darkness doesn't overtake us and that he is the one that is made known, that his light, his love, his justice, his good will be present among us and through us. Glory to Jesus Christ.
Glory to God forever.
Let us all say with our whole soul and with our whole mind the same.
Lord, have mercy.
O Lord, almighty God of our fathers, we pray you to hear and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Have mercy on us, O God, for if you bring mercy, we pray you to hear and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Yeah.
for this saving command and all that has come to pass on our behalf, the cross, the tomb, the resurrection on the third day, the ascension into heaven, the sitting at the right hand, and the second coming in glory, offering you your own from your own, always and everywhere.
We thank you, Lord.
O Lord, I believe and profess
that you are truly Christ, the Son of the living God, who came into the world to save sinners, of whom I am the first. Accept me today as partaker of your eternal supper, O Son of God, for I will not reveal your mysteries to your enemies, nor will I give you a kiss as to Judas, but like the thief I profess you. Remember me, O Lord, when you come in your kingdom. Remember me, O Master, when you come in your kingdom. Remember me, O Holy One, when you come in your kingdom. May the partaking of your holy mysteries, O Lord, be not for my judgment or condemnation, but for the healing of soul and body. O Lord, I also believe and profess that this which I am about to receive is truly your most precious body and your life-giving blood, which I pray make me worthy to receive for the remission of all my sins and for life everlasting. Amen. O God, be merciful to me, a sinner. O God, cleanse me of my sins and have mercy on me. O Lord, forgive me, for I have sinned without number.
Praise the Lord.
For I will not Behold, this has touched your lips, will take away your iniquities and cleanse you from your sin.
Blessed is our God, always, now, and ever, and forever.
We have seen the true light. We have received our heavenly Spirit. We have found the true faith, and we worship the undivided Trinity, for the Trinity has saved us.
Blessed is our God, always, now, and ever, and forever.
Amen. May our mouth be filled with your praise, O Lord, so that we may sing of your glory, sing of your glory, for you the name.
Constantinople, of the holy apostle Aquila, whose day it is, and of our holy fathers of the six ecumenical councils whom we commemorate, and through the prayers of all the saints, for Christ is good and loves us all.
Thank you.